session earlier yesterday morning. It is actually currently June 12th, 2024, and it's about 4:30 in the morning. And so this word came to me yesterday, June 11th, and God spoke to me. God whispered to me the word delight, delight, delight. Okay, so today's word is delight. Okay, and so before getting deeper into this word, God allowed me to brainstorm the words that I associate with delight without any further context. So without looking up the definition, this is what I was, you know, receiving in the spirit. It says here, brightness, brightness, sunshine, joy, love, hope, pleasure, and satisfaction. One more time. Brightness, sunshine, joy, love, hope, pleasure, and satisfaction. And so I relate all of these spiritual fruits, all of these attributes, all of these gifts, I relate this to delight. Okay, and so I would like you all to meditate on these words for a moment, and also brainstorm any other words that you will associate with delight. Okay, I also have the word indulgence. Okay, and God is giving me the phrase, you deserve to experience what you desire. Okay, you deserve to delight in your desires. And so I have a few questions. I have a few questions to prompt, to ask you all. I would love for you to take the time to reflect on these questions and really allow God to guide you. You know, allow God to guide your mind and your heart in this time. Allow you to flow and truly receive the healing and reflection that you deserve. Okay, experience the delight that you desire. So I have three questions. So the first question is, where have I been missing out on God's delight? Where have I been missing out on God's delight? The second question is, how do I delight myself in the Lord? How do I delight myself in the Lord? And the last question is, what does your heart desire? What does your heart desire? Okay, one more time, I'll read through the questions. We have three questions. The first question is, where have I been missing out on God's delight? Where have I been missing out on God's delight? The second question, how do I delight myself in the Lord? How do I delight myself in the Lord? Okay, and the last question is, what does your heart desire? What does your heart desire? And so, I have a few supporting scriptures to support this word and to also induce and encourage meditation. process, take delight in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. So to understand this verse, you need to understand how to delight in the Lord. And then you also have to understand what are the desires of your heart. Okay? And so, to break it down a little bit to help understand, I'm going to go through some of the meanings, the synonyms of delight, okay? And so really, delight just means great pleasure, okay? Great pleasure. So delight means pleasure, happiness, joy, joyfulness, glee, gladness, gratification, excitement, amusement, bliss, rapture, ecstasy, elation, and euphoria, pleasure, happiness, joy, joyfulness, glee, gladness, gratification, excitement, amusement, bliss, rapture, elation, and euphoria. And so those are the synonyms of the word delight. Okay, so once again, what does your heart desire? Because when you delight in the Lord grants your heart's desires. Okay, one way that you can delight yourself in the Lord is reading your Bible with an open, joyful heart. Okay? I have another scripture for you guys, and this is Deuteronomy 29:29. And it says here, "The sacred things belong to the Lord our God, but the things revealed belong to us and our children forever, that we may follow all of the words of this law." Again, Deuteronomy 29:29, NIV. "The sacred things belong to the Lord our God, but the things revealed belong to us and our children forever, that we may follow all the words of this law." Okay. The next scripture that I have is Luke 12:2, and this is NIV as well. Here it says, "There is nothing concealed that will not be disclosed, or hidden that will not be made known. What is done in the dark will come to the light." Okay? There is nothing concealed that will not be disclosed, or hidden that will not be made known. Okay? And so this is a season of exposure. God will always, always bring light out of the darkness. Okay? And the last scripture that I have for you guys is Jeremiah 33:3, and this is the Passion Translation, and here it says, "Cry out to me, and I will answer you. Cry out to me, and I will answer you. I will reveal to you great things, guarded secrets that you never could have known." God has all the secrets, all the recipes. God cracked all the codes already. Relationship. Relationship. How do you delight in the Lord? You strengthen that relationship. You spend spirit. When you are in pain, when you are confused, when you are frustrated, when you are angry, you praise and you worship. You take your focus off of the trouble and you turn to God. That is how you delight yourself in the Lord. Allow God to bring you peace. Step back from that relationship. Put down the weed. Put down the alcohol. Stop going out late nights. Stay in. Go to your prayer closet. Go to your secret place. Cry out to God. It doesn't have to be perfect. It does not have to be pretty. But it has to be pure and genuine. God loves you. I love you. But God loves you so, so, so much more than you will ever know. Delight in the Lord. Delight in the Lord. And He will grant the desires of your heart. And so I pray for you all to truly delight yourself in the Lord, that your heart's desires may be granted and fulfilled, that your joy may be complete, that your heart and your mind and your ears would